Hi, I'm Dr. Arjun Srinivasan, the Associate Director for Healthcare Associated Infection Prevention Programs in the Division of Healthcare Quality Promotion at CDC. I'm pleased to share with you information on the 2019 update of the CDC's core elements for hospital antibiotic stewardship programs. Used when needed, antibiotics are life-saving. However, giving patients antibiotics when they are not needed creates preventable harm. Given that 20% of patients who get an antibiotic in a hospital experience an adverse drug event, there are thousands of people we can protect by improving the way we prescribe antibiotics. The good news is that we have a solution. Many studies have shown that antibiotic stewardship programs can improve antibiotic use, leading not only to better treatment of infections, but to fewer patient harms. In 2014, CDC called on all U.S. hospitals to have an antibiotic stewardship program and developed the core elements of hospital antibiotic stewardship programs to help accomplish that goal. The core elements outlines the structures and functions associated with successful stewardship programs in a framework that can be adapted to any hospital. In 2019, we've updated the hospital core elements to reflect both lessons learned from 5 years of experience as well as new evidence from the field of antibiotic stewardship. This update comes at an important time, as the core elements are referenced in the 2019 revision of the Hospital Conditions of Participation from the Centers for Medicare and Medicaid Services. As before, there are 7 core elements of hospital antibiotic stewardship programs. The first is leadership commitment. Backing from the senior leadership of the hospital is central to the success of any quality improvement effort, and antibiotic stewardship is no exception. Hospital leadership support is essential in ensuring that the stewardship program has the staffing and resources necessary to do its job. Program leadership is the second core element. To be effective, a stewardship program must have a leader or co-leaders. Experience is demonstrating that the co-leadership by physician and pharmacist is an especially popular model and is currently in place in 59% of U.S. hospitals. The growth of physician-pharmacist co-led stewardship programs influenced a renaming of the third core element, which is now called pharmacy expertise rather than drug expertise, to reflect the key role that pharmacists must play in improving antibiotic use in hospitals. The fourth core element, action, has been revised quite a bit based on data published since 2014. It is now clear that there are 2 key interventions that are most important in reducing unnecessary antibiotic use in hospitals: prospective audit and feedback, and pre-authorization. The action core element also suggests that stewardship programs focus efforts on improving antibiotic use for 3 conditions: community-acquired pneumonia, urinary tract infection, and skin and soft tissue infection. These 3 infections account for more than half of all antibiotic use in U.S. hospitals, and studies have shown important opportunities to improve use for all 3. Tracking antibiotic use, as well as other processes and outcomes, is the 5th core element. The 2019 Core Elements Update highlights the utility of reporting antibiotic use data to CDC's National Healthcare Safety Network Antibiotic Use, or AU, option, which allows hospitals to both monitor antibiotic use and benchmark their use against other hospitals through the standardized antimicrobial administration ratio. There are currently more than 1,400 hospitals reporting data to the AU option, and that number continues to grow. The 6th core element, reporting, highlights the importance of providing information on antibiotic use and resistance to leadership and providers who can use the data for action. Education is the 7th and final core element. In addition to education for providers, the 2019 Core Elements Update highlights the importance of educating patients about antibiotics, especially with respect to potential adverse events, and underscores the importance of engaging nurses in patient education efforts. We've made tremendous progress in antibiotic stewardship programs in U.S. hospitals. In 2018, 85% of hospitals reported that they had stewardship programs with all seven of the CDC core elements. The goal now is to make those programs as effective as possible. We hope this 2019 update of the core elements for hospital antibiotic stewardship programs will serve as a valuable resource as hospitals look to expand and optimize their efforts to improve antibiotic use.